Freshies, it's your boy Jesse Havea, also known as Brita Filter, and I'm your Polynesian drag queen of New York City. We're about to take a bite out of the Big Apple, if you know what I mean. So here's what we got coming up on our show.
This is my castle where all the magic happens. Well, Brita's magic happens up in this gig.
Just because I'm Tongan doesn't mean I have the sign. Which flowers? I mean, if we're all vanilla.
It'll be boring.
Yes.
Who lives in the pineapple under the sea?
SpongeBob.
Yes,
SpongeBob.
SpongeBob, that is correct.
We're dead, and you are disgusting.
We are spilling all the tea, the jasmine, the green tea, the chamomile. Sis, this Kiki's about to be real, honey.
Nice and
really
genuine.
Nice, like really helpful.
Yeah. They could call you like, "Hi, darling," or "Hi, sweetheart," yeah. And you're like, "Oh, wow." This...
You like it?
We had a show in Auckland for the Auckland Arts Festival, and we happened to be scouted by the director of Soho Playhouse. He came and saw our show one night, and was like, "You know, I need the show in Soho Playhouse," and so they were able to make it happen with our executive producer, Victor Rogers.
I feel like America is a place that we look at so much and been so inspired by via pop culture or whatever. So I was like, I wonder if people will actually understand like what we're literally saying as well as like more metaphorically.
Growing up, I used to watch wrestling all the time with my granddad, and my favorite wrestler was Eddie Guerrero.
Contours of Heaven, six rangatahi that live in Hawke's Bay. That we've got to know, and we're here because their voices have reached to this beautiful place and is diverse to home, but also similar.
Even though I live in Auckland, and from what I understand, the whānau who made Wild Dogs under my skirt are also based in Auckland. It's going to be so special, I think, to see that show here in the New York context. But also, like, hearing Te Reo Māori being sung by the Modern Māori Quartet, like, in this little playhouse in Soho, it felt really, like, revolutionary and cool, and I felt so proud.
We are here performing at the Soho Playhouse, and our show is called Two Worlds. It's basically about four Māori men in an interesting scenario, singing and performing.
Calm down. This place is magic, and if you can make it here, then you're here.
We are dusky maidens, and we have never slept with our cousins.
I think it's about navigating between different cultural landscapes. You could be in New York and it looks like everybody from different countries,
all walks of life.
All walks of life come to this place.
The thrift stores,
yeah.
Oh my goodness, we like spend a whole day there. And
this whole city is amazing. I can't stop seeing every movie I've ever watched.
Yeah, I have quite a bit of pizza.
My suit is tight.
Man, I hope people over here in New York can get a flavour of New Zealand that's not just the All Blacks, sheep and Lord of the Rings, you know? And I think that it's a cool showcase having the Wild Dogs under my skirt, having that perspective of New Zealand as well as Anna Scottney and her and Contours and us too.
My name is Beau Louis Takapu. I am a Tongan American living in Auckland, New Zealand, and I am a full-time fashion designer. The best part is that I get to bring all bring my visions into life. I think the most recent one was Project Runway. You know, I haven't done it. I mean, I do my one-offs here and there, but then when it was such a consistent thing of creating and designing and, you know, just making clothes, it kind of just opened up the gates again. You know, when I first arrived to New Zealand, you know, I heard that South Pacific designs were frowned upon. You know, first of all, I think it's second of all, I think times have changed. You know, Islanders comes from all walks of life and they all have a different perspective. And that's what makes this beautiful thing. Just because I'm Tongan doesn't mean I have to design witch flowers. I mean, if we're all vanilla.
It'll be boring.
Yes.
This collection, you know, it's my inspiration was through Her Royal Highness Princess Bulebu. The softness of the fabrics, the cashmeres, the silk, you know, reflects who she is as a woman. You know, my ultimate goal is to work towards becoming the first haute couture of the South Pacific. I think first and foremost, the courage comes in many forms. So for my graduate collection from Wycliffe, and it was, I used tabo cloth for the first time, and then how can I do that? And rather than listening to the outside noise, I kind of just did it. First and foremost, be you. Because at least you know then that everything that you do was all you. You know, was all authentically you. And that's probably more important than anything else.
Come back after the break, and I'm gonna show you a little bit of my gig, girl. And I'm gonna show you my world, honey. Hey!
New Zealand?
Yeah, one more. Okay.
And we got Nuku'alofa.
I love it. People don't know what I am, especially on the East Coast. People are like, wait, what's Tongan? Back to Fresh. I'm your boy Jesse Havea, aka Brita Filter, also known as the Moana of Manhattan. And welcome to my world. Oh my goodness, come into my room. This is my castle where all the magic happens. Well, Brita's magic happens up in this gig. I have all of my wigs that I wear. You know, it keeps on getting more and more and more and more, and it just gets crazier and crazier. But it's nice to have them up so they get the hell out of the way. And yes, we have our lovely neon for anyone who walks up into this gig who forgets who the head in charge is right there. This is where I've become very successful in this small ass room in Manhattan.
What you looking at?
I grew up Mormon, so we were LDS. We were very like into. We were very musical. We were a very musical family. I saw my first theater show, The Phantom of the Opera, when I was in the sixth grade, and it changed my life forever. I was like, when I grow up, that's what I want to do. I want to perform. So then I went to school for musical theater, college. And then it kind of just transitioned into drag. I was honestly so sick of doing these old white people musicals that I wanted to create my own platform and talk about things that I wanted to talk about instead of playing the Tongan bitch to the left in South Pacific. If I have to do that one more time, it wasn't gonna happen. I went to my first drag show in Phoenix, Arizona, and it was my first experience seeing a drag queen, but I remember feeling like uneasy because I didn't really know this world. These men up in these gowns looking fabulous, giving the most intricate performance I've ever seen, the most amazing lip syncing. I mean, I was doing that in my room as like a fifth grader, just trying to live my fantasy, and this bitch was doing it and trying to win money. I was like, this is amazing. I get so hot. As a Tongan man, I hate being too hot and wearing all this bullshit and having my strapped to my that sucks. I remember my auntie, when she found out that I was doing drag, she was like, before you become too big, you need to go to Tonga and you need to do the Miss Galaxy pageant. And I had no idea what this pageant was. I watched it on YouTube. It is everything. I want to be a judge. If you're watching this, I want to be a judge on that pageant. My dad is from the kingdom of Tonga. He lives in Hawaii now. So my dad is like FOB, fresh off the boat. And my mom is like this cute little white lady from Ohio. I love it. People don't know what I am, especially on the East Coast. People are like, wait, what's Tongan? I mean, now, since we had like the Olympics and we have some other Polynesian people coming out, but I think I'm like the first mainstream Polynesian Tongan drag queen.
You're thirsty?
Having RuPaul really changed a lot of things for me. People are afraid and people make assumptions over things that they're not sure of. Now it's on the mainstream, so like people don't look at it weird as much, but more of as a LGBTQIA plus artistic platform. My dad's side of the family, my Tongan side of the family, is incredibly Mormon. So it took a lot of education and for them to realize that it's for entertainment purposes. That's why I do drag. I don't think they realized until they could pay the bills that they were okay with it. And then they started to see me on TV and they're like, well, if he's on TV, I was like, oh. Of course you like it now because I'm on TV. But when I wasn't on TV, I'll see you now. Making sure that I have a balance and that I have, I take care of Jesse and not only Brita all the time. So make sure I get that good eats too, not just Brita. My sister got this for me for Christmas one year and I keep it at the front of the door. And this is specifically a rainbow mantapa, kind of bridges the gap between me being LGBTQIA+, but also having, being a Tongan man and woman at night. So I really love it and it reminds me of my heritage and my family that I love so much.
It's Friday night. And your man calls, and he says,
babe, I'm going out tonight.
You're what?
Make a scene. Just kidding.
When your man calls you and says that he's going out, do not start a fight. Who's that
Pati.
In the background?
Who's
Pati, that in
the background? He's got the line.
And on the
and
eyebrow.
And he's got his eyebrow.
Why you got a line through your eyebrow like that?
Who's Leave him.
Instead, ask yourself this. Do I love this man? Do I trust this man? Do I know this man?
Sorry to this man.
Tip number one.
Keep busy.
Read a good book.
Call your dad.
Go to work.
Do the ganga mea that you have been ignoring for 3 days.
Vacuum the house.
Anything.
Look after your sister.
Start a business.
Tip number two. Don't overthink.
You don't need to know the license and registration number of the sober driver, okay?
Malo
lo.
Malo
le.
Malo lo sunga.
Farmalosi.
Izobes and kangays.
Because chances are it's probably all in your head.
Exactly.
So you're working yourself up for nothing.
Unless you are working yourself up for something.
Who hurt you? Leave that man alone.
Do not blow up his phone.
Don't be texting him and asking him to send you photos with a fork in his head to prove that it's a photo that he's just taken with his friends.
Please don't do that. That is crazy.
She's done it.
Maybe.
All in all, relationships are built on trust, and it's important to let your partner make his own decisions, including going out with his boys.
Exactly. And listen, sis. If you don't want to get harassed when you go out, then it's best not to harass your boyfriend, because when the time comes for you to go out, he's gonna be blowing up your phone.
Uh-huh.
So don't chill it.
And that's us. Come back next week.
More freshness coming after these not-so-important messages.
You're beautiful.
Thank you so much.
The bum sauce, was it?
I'm so sorry. Right, so.
The bum sauce is just behind.
Contestant number three, what is your name?
Hi, my name is Adele.
Yeah! Welcome back to Fresh in New York City. And now back to your weekly dose of fresh things.
Kia ora, beautiful people, and welcome back to another episode of How Fresh Are You? And today we are very lucky because it's the first time they've ever been part of our game show from Tone 6. On my left, we have Sio and Viliami. Yeah!
Good.
And what's the name of your team?
We are Team Prime Sauce.
Oh, Team Prime Sauce, yeah! And on the right, we got liquor and peaches. And what's the name of your team?
We are Dream Team.
Oh, Dream Team. So there you have it. Dream Team on my right, on my left, Prime Sauce. And we're gonna start with the game we always start with, and that is rapid fire, yeah! And our first question, name three Pacific Islands starting with the letter N. Yes, Dream Team?
Niue.
Niue. Three more seconds. Three. Two. One.
New Zealand.
New Zealand, yeah, one more. Okay.
And we got Nuku'alofa. Wow. It's the capital of Tonga.
Country. Okay, no point. Nauru. Nauru is the other one. What is the 50th state in America? We're going to give it here to Dream Team.
Say Hawaii.
Hawaii, that's correct. Hawaii is the 50th state. What is the name of the Maori singer-songwriter that won the Australian Idol?
Stan Walker.
Oh, that's right. This question is a hard one. Who lives in the pineapple undersea?
SpongeBob.
That is correct. SpongeBob. Do you get time to do homework when you're watching? If you was to find yourself in a place called Liku, which Pacific island would you be in? Yes, Dream Team?
Niue.
That is correct, Niue is the answer. Liku is in Niue. These scales are too quick. Dream Team leading at the moment with 87 points and Sio 107. The bum sauce, was it?
I'm sauce,
right,
I'm sauce.
The bum sauce. It's just behind. But now, because that is our rapid fire, still a close game, we're gonna take you to our next game to see who's gonna win The Voice.
This is The Voice.
Now, let's listen to The Voice and guess who it is. Yes, Pump Sauce?
Chick Chin AP.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Very famous hip hop in New Zealand. 3 points. Team Prime Sauce. Got that one right there.
Prime Sauce.
Huh? Let's go for our second voice. See if you can guess who it is.
Jeez. Welcome to the party. I am the youngest in the Williams family.
Yes.
That's Rosie.
Oh, these guys are too good. Hey, Rosie, it is.
Let's go.
Let's go. Now, Team Pump Shows are leading by 50 points. Come on, Dream Team, let's see what you got. Or you can go home now. Let's go for our third voice.
He was my inspiration growing up. He's one of my favorite actors, and so I
Yes, Pump Shows.
That's Jason Momoa.
Yes, it is. There you go. Yeah.
Let's go.
Oh, Dream Team, do you just stay dreaming or what? Let's go for our next voice and see if we know who it is. Yes?
Paris Google.
There you have it. Dream Team coming back with our last voice now. Still a close game. Let's see who this voice belongs to. Yes, Dream Team.
My Moa music.
Yes, there you have it. Congratulations. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Our winner for our Health Fresher Year today is the Dream Team. Yeah, my big hand. Thank you to Peaches and Linda. And also another big hand to Pump Sauce, here to Viliami and Theo. All right. But you know what? Because I love Tone 6 so much, you are all going to take some prizes away.
Let's go.
We've got some fresh TV, T-shirt here for the winning team. And for the losers, we also got some T-shirts here for you guys. But for you guys, you are the winners. You take a Westfield card. Just got Westfield's name on it, nothing inside. So thank you very much for coming. And next week, we hope to catch you once again on How Fresh Are You? Yeah!
Thank you so much for joining me here in New York City. Make sure you tune in next week for your daily dose of freshness, honey.
Kia ora, I'm Hani Hirime.
Talofa, I'm Maito Frederica.
Welcome to Fresh. Keep it fresh.